Friends, in this video, we are detailedly study about the speed-torque relations in concern with your induction motor drive. So, let's begin. In this video, we are detailedly study about the review of the speed-torque relations. So, friends, let's first of all, we can understand what is necessity requirement for the speed-torque relations. So, friends, we know that from the basic of your electrical machines, motor is a device basically that will convert electrical energy into mechanical energy. So the motor is a device which will convert that electrical energy into a mechanical energy. Electrical energy is converted into a mechanical energy. So friends, as we know that the mechanical energy, that will be the power generated from your motoring, it is mechanical power. So the formula of the mechanical power, first of all we can get in the concept, that is mechanical power is equal to, or it will be equal to the product of torque into speed. Okay, so friends, that will be the basic fundamental formula of the mechanical power. So T is called as torque and N is called as speed. So from the power which will be getting from your motor is basically your mechanical power, and the mechanical power is getting from the basic equation of your torque and speed. So friends, in this way, in concern with your motoring operation, whether it should be your induction motor, whether it should be your DC motor, we want to understand of basic torque speed relationship of motor. So friends, in concern with the induction motor drive, now we can detailedly study about the torque and the speed characteristics of your induction motor. So friends, in concern with your induction motor, if you want to get the value of the speed, we are having the value, that is the synchronous speed is equal to, that will be the speed of your rotating magnetic field, and the value of your synchronous speed is 120 f upon p, where we call it as f is equal to frequency, and P is called as the number of frequency, and P is called as number of pole. So we are getting the value of the speed. So this will be the synchronous speed. So if you want to get the value of the rotor speed, so we are having the formula of rotor speed, that is ns into 1 minus s. So this will be the value of your rotor speed. Okay, where s is called as slip, and slip is equal to ns minus nr upon ns, where ns is called as the synchronous speed, nr is called as the rotor speed, and these are the formula of the ns and nr. So friends, and this will be the value of your slip of your induction motor. So friends, while we are studying the speed torque relationship, we are getting the value of the speed. Okay, so this is called as n. We can consider this value of speed in terms of rpm. Now we can find out the value of the torque. What should be the value of the torque? So friends, in previous video, we had already derived fundamental torque equation of your this induction motor. So what should be the equation of your torque? That is the torque equation of your induction motor. So the torque equation of your induction motor is basically we have derived. It is 3 divided by omega ms. It is called as omega ms because as we have fundamental relationship of your torque and speed, means we have the relationship of omega m is equal to 2 pi n by 60. So we can convert the value of this angular velocity into speed, or we can convert the value of the speed into angular velocity by this formula. So this will be the value of the omega ms, means that will be the value of the synchronous speed, that is called as the synchronous velocity of your problem. And in concern with the fundamental torque equation, we can considering this term. So this is the fundamental torque equation in which V is called as the voltage. It is R dash R upon S, where R dash R is called as a rotor resistance referred to your stator. This is the value of slip, and the formula of that particular slip is called as NS minus NR upon NS. Okay. So in concern with, while we are calculating the value of the speed in terms of the angular velocity, so it will be omega MS minus omega M divided by omega MS. So this will be the value of slip in concern with your induction motor. So we are having the fundamental torque equation, that is Rs plus R dash R upon S, because this will be the term related to your slip, bracket square plus Xs plus X dash R bracket square. So this will be the fundamental torque equation of your induction motor that we had already derived in a earlier video. So this will be the relationship of your torque and this will be the value of your speed. So friends, if we are getting the value of this torque into speed, then we can getting the value of the mechanical power. Okay, so that's why the detailed understanding of the speed torque relations is very, very important in concern with your induction motor operation. So friends, we can find out what will be the value of your different torque in concern with your maximum torque. So for sake of that, now we can write first of all the basic fundamental equation of torque for your sake of understanding. Now I can write this equation. So we have the value of your torque. So the value of torque is T is equal to, again I can write, that is 3 divided by omega ms in bracket. You can write it as V square, that is R dash R upon S divided by Rs plus R dash R divided by S bracket square plus, that is Xs plus X dash R bracket square. So this will be the value of your torque. Now we can consider this will be the equation number first. So in that particular torque, V is the voltage. The value of the R dash R is called as a rotor resistance referred to stator. The value of S is slip. This is the stator value of resistance. This is the stator value of your reactance. This will be the rotor value of reactance referred to your stator. So friends, now we want to get value of T max. We will get the maximum value of torque. It is called as T max. Now we call it as T max. But in concern with your basically induction motor, the condition while we are getting the value of the Tmax is R2 is equal to, or we called it as RR is equal to, that is rotor resistance is equal to S into X2, we called it as XR. Okay, so this will be the condition for the maximum torque of your three-phase induction motor. Means we are getting the value of the Tmax, that is maximum torque at that particular position. So friends, we can get the value of the slip at that particular Tmax. So we call it as the value of Smax. Smax is the value of your slip at maximum, because previously the value of the slip is called as the omega ms minus omega m divided by omega ms. But while we are getting the value of the Tmax, that is maximum torque for your particular operation, we can understand this value of your torque in concern with the waveform. So we are getting the value of the Smax. So we can get this value of the Smax by substituting the value of your slip into that particular equation. Okay, so we can get the value of slip, that is Smax, and the value of the slip is now, it is R dash R divided by square root of, that is Rs square plus Xs plus X dash R bracket square. This will be the value of your slip at maximum, that is Smax. So friends, now we call it as the equation number 2. So friends, in that particular equation, we are getting the value of the positive sign and negative sign. So friends, in that particular, positive sign will be indicates for your motoring operation, because as we know that the drive will be operated in 4 quadrant of operation. Negative sign indicates it is a braking operation. So as we know that the induction motor works as an induction generator for in concern with your braking operation. So this positive sign will be indicates the value of the Tmax is for your motoring operation, and the negative sign will be indicates that the value of your Smax, because this is very, very important in concern with your Tmax. So the value of the Smax, if it is negative, then obviously induction motor will be works as an induction generator. Now we can substitute this value of your Smax into that particular equation number 1. So now we can substitute value of, now we can substitute value, we can substitute value in 1, that is equation number 1. Means in equation number 1, we can substitute this value of your slip. It will be the slip responsible to your resistance. Okay, now we can substitute the value of the slip. But friends, this value of the R dash R upon S, this would be the one of the term in concern with your rotor circuit. So this term will be indicated as 1, or this will be, because at the starting of your induction motor, the value of your slip is 1. So we are getting this term common 1. So now we can substitute the value of S into, that is the S max into that particular equation. So we are getting the equation of your torque. So what would be the value of your torque? Now we can get in, friends, that is 3 divided by omega ms in bracket v square r dash r, because this is r dash r is not a single term, divided by s, this will be the whole term in concern with your rotor circuit. So that's, we are not substituting with the value of the slip into that particular equation. So this is rs plus r dash r, okay, divided by, now we want to substitute the value of your slip at maximum. So what should be the value of the slip at maximum? Now we will substitute the value of the slip at maximum at that particular point. So we are getting the value, that is r dash r divided by square root of r s square plus x s plus x dash r bracket square. So this should be the value of your what? Slip. Okay, we are getting the square of this whole term plus xs plus x dash r bracket square bracket complete. Means, friends, in this equation we are substituting the value of s. So we are substituting the value of s. So we are substituting the value of s with the help of that particular s max in that particular max equation. Okay, so we can get, so this will be the equation of your T max, because we want to get the value of the torque at maximum. Okay, so we can get the equation. So we can get the equation of your T max. So the value of T max is now what? T max is equal to, I can write the term, that will be the term, that is R dash S will be getting constant, that is 1. We are getting the value, that is V square, but before V square, we are having the constant term, that is 3 omega ms in bracket V square divided by value of Rs. So friends, in that previous equation, we can see this value of your R dash get cancelled, because this R dash get cancelled, and this will be the numerator value comes into the denominator in terms of particular value. So we are getting the value of your equation. So what should be the value of your equation? We can get this value, that is Rs plus square root of, that is Rs square plus Xs plus X dash R bracket square. So this will be the term, plus Xs plus X dash R bracket square. So this will be the term of your T max. So friends, in that particular term, now we will get the value of this derivative of this term, because this term is basically in concern with your circuit. So now we can get this term. So we can take these two common, that is the outside. So we can getting the term, that is 3 divided by omega ms bracket v square divided by, it is 2 into Rs plus square root of Rs square plus Xs plus X dash R bracket square. Okay, so, and again this 2 will be getting here, plus this will be the different term. Now we can write here, that is plus 2 into Xs plus X dash R. So this will be the term. So friends, basically the value of your Xs and XR dash, and basically R dash R upon S, this value is basically terms to the value of your, we can getting the value of the derivative of this term. So the derivative of this constant term is 0. So 0 into 2. So this whole term will be 0. Okay. And now we can getting only this term. So now we can take these two That will be the outside, that is 3 divided by 2 omega ms in bracket, that is v square divided by rs plus square root of rs square plus xs plus x dash r bracket square. So you can get the value of your max. So this will be the equation of your T max. So what do you mean by the T max? It is the maximum equation of your torque when the value of S will be the S max. So now we called it as, this will be the equation number 3. And this is the equation of your breakdown torque, because as we know that maximum torque is, again we can rewrite, that is maximum torque. We can write this maximum torque is also called as the breakdown torque. It is breakdown torque. Breakdown torque of your motor. So from equation, we can see that is T max, that is the maximum torque we will be getting from the equation. Okay. So the value of the T max is basically the value of the T max will not be dependent on, will not be dependent on, basically dependent on rotor resistance, because friends, as we seen that rotor resistance in the value of your maximum torque, there is no term in concern with your rotor resistance. Okay, so these all terms are in concern with your stator and the value of the reactances. So Tmax will not be responsible in concern with your rotor resistance. But friends, we are having the value of slip, okay, so that will be the very important terms, because the maximum torque, it doesn't dependent upon the resistance. So friends, in concern with your induction motor, we are having the value of your speed torque characteristics while increasing the value of the resistance. So resistance will not affect. So while we are changing the value of the resistance, the value of the Tmax remain the same, because Tmax is doesn't depend on your rotor resistance. But in the other ways, we are having the formula of the slip at maximum, that is Sm. So we are writing again the equation, that is S max or Sm is equal to plus or minus, we are getting the equation, that is R dash R divided by, we are getting, that is square root of, that is Rs square plus Xs plus X dash R bracket square. So from that particular equation, friends, we can see that the value of slip at maximum will be dependent on your resistance. Means if you are increasing the value of your resistance, because the S is directly proportional to, or S max is directly proportional to R dash R. So the value of the slip max, that is Sm, is dependent upon resistance, but the value of your torque, it doesn't depend on your rotor resistance. So that will be the very important equation in concern with your torque, that is called as a breakdown torque. Okay, so friends, most of the time we are drawing such type of characteristics, that is the speed characteristics of your motor. So we can increasing the value of the resistance. Okay, so this will be the value of your torque. This is torque and this is the speed characteristics. So friends, we know that the value of the T max, so this is the T max value, because this is the maximum torque. Value of the Tmax is doesn't dependent, because this will be the resistance 1, this is will be the characteristic resistance 2 and resistance 3. So by the changing of the value of the resistance, the value of the Tmax remaining the same. That will be the fundamental concept we are getting. So this will be the basic relationship or the review of your speed torque characteristics. What should be the effect of the changing of the resistance while we are drawing the value of your Tmax. Okay, so this will be the very important thing. So friends, after that we can understand, we can draw what will be the basically relationship between the torque developed and the maximum torque. So we can take the ratio for understanding. So we can take ratio, we can take ratio of T by T max. So we have the formula, we can take the ratio, that is T divided by max. So friends, we can take relationship. So what should be that particular ratio, because T is the developed torque of your motor, and at that particular T we are getting the value of S. Okay, and at the T Tmax, what do you mean by the Tmax? It will be the maximum torque of your motor at the value of Sm. So we are having the value of S, that is omega ms minus omega m, that is omega ms minus omega m divided by omega ms, and the value of Sm, we call it as Sm, that is plus minus r dash r divided by r s square plus xs plus x dash r bracket square. Okay, so these are the value, that is T and T max. Now we can substitute this value of T and T max into that particular equation. So we can getting very important term. Okay, so now we can substitute the value of it is T divided by, I can write T max. Now I can substitute the value of T. What should be the value of the T? So the value of the T we are having T divided by omega ms in bracket, it is V square R dash R upon S divided by R S plus R dash R divided by S bracket square plus XS plus x dash r bracket square. This should be the value of the T divided by value of T max. So what should be the value of the T max that we had already derived? It is 3 by 2 omega ms in bracket, that is V square divided by R s plus R s square plus xs plus x dash r bracket square. So now we can take the ratio of this term. So for we are getting this term get cancelled, and by the changing of this term with respect to the value of your S max, now we can substitute again the value of the slip into that particular equation, that is S. But in concern with that, we want to substitute the value of the S max, and we are getting the equation. So from mathematical simplification, we are getting the value of the T my max is equal to, okay. So we are getting this term, that is T by omega ms, that will be the 2 will be replicate, that will be the come to your numerator. So we are getting value that is 2 into 1 plus rs divided by r dash r into sm, because we are taking the value of this slip. So this will be the sm divided by, we are getting value that is s divided by sm plus sm divided by s plus 2 into, that will be the rs divided by r dash r into sm. So we are getting the value of T by T max. Now we called it as the ratio of T by T max. So friends, as we seen that this will be the term, that is RS divided by R dash R into SM, the value of the slip at the starting, that will be the 1. And this term is basically the negligible value, because as we know that while we are taking this value of term, that will be the negligible value. So friends, while we are calculating the value of the T by T max, we know that the value of this term will be negligible. Okay, so that's why we can remove this term. Okay, so if you calculate this value is negligible, means that will be the value is 0. So 0 into 2, that will be the term, which will be the 0. So we are getting one of the important equation of your T by T max from that particular equation, that is T by T max. That will, we are getting the equation, that is 2 divided by S divided by Sm plus Sm divided by S. So this will be the very, very important equation that we are getting from the T by T max. So now we call it as the equation number 4, and this will be from your basic equation. So friends, we can analyze a different term in concern with that. So again, I can write the equation of your T by T max, because we want to understand the ratio of this term, that is where T by dmax is equal to, I can write this equation again for your sake of understanding, that is 2 divided by S divided by Sm plus Sm divided by S. So this will be the equation, important equation. Now we can elaborate what are the different terminology in concern with that particular equation. So we are getting this is the value of your T by Tmax. So here is called as the motor torque, that is motor developed torque, Tmax is called as maximum torque, that will be the maximum torque, or sometime we called it as breakdown torque, that will be the breakdown torque. Breakdown torque, value of S, it will be the slip at normal condition. Sm is called as slip at maximum. So this will be the relationship of your torque speed understanding. Friends, from that particular relationship of torque and speed characteristics, we can understand a basic torque speed relationship of your induction motor. I can write speed at y-axis and torque at x-axis. That will be the different analysis. We can only replace the basic quadrants, or we can only changing the basic axis. Okay, so we are getting the speed torque characteristics, that will be the for your torque. This will be the value of your Tmax. So this will be the first graph. Now I can write the second graph in concern with that. Okay, so this second graph I can write in that particular graph as well. So this will be the graph, the second graph. It is synchronous speed, that is omega ms, with respect to the current ir. This is the rotor current. This will be the ir. So this will be the value of your rotor current of your induction motor. So this will be the torque speed relationship concerned with your T by Tmax. Okay, so this will be the very, very important term. So now we can bring the graph in concern with your D bar and double cage bar. So first upon, we can understand what do you mean by the D bar induction motor and what do you mean by the double cage induction motor. So friends, as we know that the induction motor is basically classified according to its rotor construction. The rotor construction is look like a squirrel cage. It is called as a squirrel cage induction motor, but sometime basically the rotor circuit which will be having the value of the D bar. So friends, now we can see from the diagram. So as shown in diagram, friends, this will be the rotor bars. As we seen that this will be the value of your rotor bar and this will be the value of the leakage flux. So in concern with the deep rotor bar, the value of leakage flux is more in concern with that particular circuit. So that's why the speed torque for your basically D bar will be shown like that. So the speed torque relationship of your D bar will be shown like that. So this will be the speed characteristics of your D bar. We can see this will be the speed characteristics of your D bar. Okay. And we are having a general purpose, that is squirrel cage induction motor speed characteristics. This will be the general purpose, or we call it as the squirrel cage induction motor characteristics. So this will be the general purpose characteristics. Okay. So if the value of the slip is more, so the value of the slip is high, so we can getting the speed torque characteristics look like that, because this is speed and this will be the torque. Okay. So if the value of the slip is look like that is high slip, so we are getting that torque speed characteristics or the curve look like that. So this will be the torque speed relationship. Means we are getting the torque speed curve according to the different rotor construction of your induction motor. So according to the motor is a simple squirrel cage, I can raise all the terms and I can show you. If the motor is a simple, that is squirrel cage induction motor, then the speed torque curve like look like that. So this will be the torque speed relationship. If the motor will be having the dip bar, then the speed torque characteristics is look like that. If the value of the slip is more, or we call it as the high value slip, so then the speed torque characteristics is look like that. If we are using the motor that is called as a double cage induction motor, so double cage induction motor, we are using, or we can divide the rotor circuit that is into two bars. First one is a top bar and second one is the bottom bar. So due to that, the value of the leakage flux will be the less as compared to your dip bar. So we are getting the speed torque relationship in concern with your double cage induction motor will be look like that. So this will be the representation of your speed torque characteristics of your double cage induction motor. So friends, in this way we have drawn the characteristics number first, general purpose, then second, that is for your dip bar, then third for your high slip, and fourth for your double cage induction motor. So in this way we have studied the different types of torque speed relationship in concern with your induction motor drive. So friends, now we can see the basic characteristics of your induction motor. So as we know that there are different quadrants of operation, so this will be the torque speed characteristics. So we are drawing the value of your speed onto your x-axis and torque into y-axis. So friends, as we seen that, as we have derived the different equation of Tmax, so friends, this will be the value of the Tm, which will be represented by the value of the Tmax, that is the maximum torque value. Maximum torque we are getting when the value of the slip is maximum. Okay, so this will be the value is Tmax. So similarly friends, we are having, this will be the motor will be operated in first quadrant. So as we know that when the motor will be operated as a, because we are getting the value of the Smax is positive and negative. So if the value of the slip is positive, then it will be operated in motoring. But if the value of the Smax is negative, so obviously your induction motor characteristics, if we are increasing again the value of the speed, then the induction motor will be works as an induction generator. So this will be the operation of your generating reason. Okay, so this will be the torque speed relationship of your induction motor drive. Okay, so friends, now we can drawing the same characteristics by the understanding of again the basic very fundamental principle of your induction motor. So friends, we are having the value of the synchronous speed 120 f/p, f is frequency, p is the number of poles, power we are getting, that is power, that is mechanical power, that will be the product of torque into speed. So we have already derived the torque and speed relationship, so T is called as torque in Newton meters. So friend, this will be the characteristics of your torque, this will be the y-axis, this will be the characteristics of your speed on your x-axis, so this will be the rotor speed. Okay, so if we are increasing the value of your speed, that is zero, so we are getting the curve look like that, and this is for your motoring operation. And obviously this will be induction motor, now it will be working as an induction generator, so we are getting the curve in concern with the generating action. So this will be the quadrant number first, as we know that this will be the quadrant number first, this will be the quadrant number fourth. So the operation that will be the called it as the motoring operation and braking operation of your induction motor. So friends, in this way we have derived the different speed characteristics and the review of the different speed torque relationship of your induction motor. So friends, from that particular equation, we are getting very important term, because the torque speed relationship or torque speed characteristics has a vital role in concern with your induction motor. So friends, in this way, we have studied the different torque speed relationships, that is the review of your torque speed characteristics. Okay. So thank you.